Welcome to CCBC TV's Arts Showcase, a series featuring performances from the campuses of the Community College of Baltimore County. I'm Monica Otal, Professor of Music and Concert Manager at CCBC. Today's Arts Showcase features the District 5, a wind quintet based in the Washington, D.C. area. They specialize in contemporary works and original transcriptions, showcasing their virtuosity and the endless possibilities of the Woodwind Quintet. Their members include flutist Laura Kaufman, oboist Alison Lowell, clarinetist Nina Elhassan, bassoonist Eddie Rumzis, and horn player Laura Crook Brisson. They will perform a transcription written for them of Chopin's 24 Preludes, Opus 28.
We just want to say a quick thank you, and we're really happy to be here playing Chopin's 24 Preludes for you. We just want to let you know that we're going to play these in three sets, and the first set that you're going to hear is Preludes 1 through 8. We ask that you just hold your applause until the end of each set, and that would be great. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. I'm Laura. I just wanted to take this break to tell you a little bit about what was going on in Chopin's life when he wrote these preludes, because it is quite interesting. Super quick background. He was born in Poland in the early 1800s at a time when Poland was politically peaceful, but he spent most of his young adult professional life in Paris, where he was composing, performing, teaching quite regularly. And it was in Paris that he met quite an interesting figure in his life, a woman who was named by herself George Sand. Now, George Sand posed a very scandalous figure in Paris in the 1830s. She would wear men's clothes and smoke cigars in public. She was a bohemian, politically radical, quite the woman. So naturally, Chopin and George fell madly in love. Their relationship caused quite the stir, so to avoid the gossip, they decided to spend the winter of 1838 in what was then the remote island of Majorca. And it was here that Chopin was diagnosed with tuberculosis. So this disease would now dominate the rest of his life. The locals in Majorca were afraid of being infected, so they forced Chopin, George Sand, and her two young kids to give up the rooms they were renting and take up residence in this abandoned monastery. And it is here in this monastery that Chopin wrote the preludes that you're hearing today. So they're, you know, they're poetic masterpieces, short bursts of profound emotion. So you can only imagine just the turmoil he's going through at this time. And I hope you hear it in some of these preludes as we continue with prelude number 9, and we'll go through until prelude 15. Then we'll break again.
Thank you. we wanted to say just a few words about how this piece came to be, not from the original historical standpoint, but how is it a Woodwind Quintet is playing this piece? As you might know, Chopin is very much associated with the piano. Of course, these pieces were originally for solo piano, as almost everything he wrote was. It's such a fantastic piece that we really knew it was something that we wanted to have in our repertoire. This piece is actually the culmination of a year-long collaboration with a composer named David Plylar, and he specifically worked with us transcribing this piece. There were lots of challenges, things like the fact that we have to breathe. Is not the pianist don't, but in a little bit of a different way. And also the difference between having one person in charge of all 10 fingers versus many more sets, and making it so that it didn't just sound like a literal reduction of the piece and just spreading out the lines on the woodwinds, but rather making it sound like it was originally for these instruments. They're so lyrical, they're so beautiful and passionate. It fits so well with the medium of a quintet, and we're excited to share this with you, and we'll continue with now with number 16.
Thank you.
So you may be thinking, that didn't sound Allegro Appassionato. That's because that was number 23, and we're about to play number 24. Just wanted to say again before we play this last one, thank you for having us here. We're so thrilled to be able to come and play this piece for you. It's been a long journey for us to work through all of these and all of the emotions and different possible interpretations. So we hope that you've enjoyed the journey through all of them with us today. If you're interested in finding out more about us, feel free to check out our website, district5quintet.org. We also have a Facebook page and Twitter and Instagram. Anything you can imagine, pretty much we're there. So feel free to look us up, and thank you again for listening.
I hope you enjoyed this performance by the District 5. If you would like to attend a Music Forum concert, please note that each Friday during the fall and spring semesters, the Music Department of CCBC presents Music Forum concerts at 12:20 in the Recital Hall of the Arts and Humanities Hall on the Essex campus. These concerts are an integral part of our students' education, and all of the concerts are free and open to the public. For more information on Music Forum, please call 443-840-1521 or visit our website at ccbcmd.edu/performingarts. I'm Monica Otal. Thank you for watching CCBC TV's Arts Showcase.